ओके, हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम एचरेश. ओके, वी आर डिस्कस्ड अबाउट मास स्पेक्ट्रोमीटर. फर्स्ट वन आई विल से दैट व्हाट इज मास, व्हाट इज स्पेक्ट्रोमीटर. फर्स्ट वन आई विल डिस्कस्ड अबाउट इट. ओके, व्हाट इज मास? मास इज अ लार्ज बॉडी ऑफ मैटर विथ नो डेफिनेट शेप. इट इज कॉल्ड मास. ओके, the large body of matter, you know, this matter, anything mass occupied by space is called matter. Okay, the large body of matter which no definite shape, in mass no definite shape, that like you called we called as mass. Okay, what is spectrometer? Spectrometer means measurement of the interaction between the light and matter. Yeah, it is called spectrometer. Okay, now we are discussed about the diagram of a mass spectrometer. First part is inject sample. Okay, first part is inject sample. Yeah, in this inject sample, electron source is there. And second part is heated to vaporize sample. In this part, heat is vaporized. Okay, third part is electron beams ionize sample. In this part, electrons are moving. Okay, the fourth part is particle accelerated into the magnetic field. By reason of the magnetic, particles are accelerated, particles are moves. Okay, for the fifth part is charged particle beam. Okay, for the reason of magnet means, you know, it is called type, it is called attraction. By the reason of magnetic, charged particles are change the direction. It like bending. It is called bending. Okay. Magnetic field separates the particle based on the mass by charge ratio. Okay. That is called lightest part is there and heaviest, and detector is there. Okay. And we represent as x plus and y plus ratios also, and z plus ratios also. It is called mass spectroscopy. Okay, mass spectrometer has enabled to biology to move from identifying single proteins to protein-wide characterization and quantification. With the development of this tool, researchers can now feasible begin defining biochemical pathway on kinetic basis, which will help us understanding the mechanistic response of cells to changing environment. Okay, it is was a protein movement. Anyone single protein, proteins are movement. Okay, peptides and hospitals, drugs and crime scenes, practical uses of mass spectroscopy. Drug companies and researchers are using the technique for drug discovery, for gaining information on drug metabolism and for pharmacokinetic studies, and the study of proteins through mass spectrometry is now added by information obtained from the genome sequence projects. The technique has also found medical issues such as neonatal screening, blood analysis, and drug testing. These uses also make mass spectroscopy, when coupled with other analytical techniques, a powerful tool in forensic analysis. Mass spectroscopy used in different fields by different methods, in the medical field, in a chemical field, biological field, that like.
Sir, okay, I have a question. Can you
tell me
where we can use the mass spectrometry?
Yeah, so like simply you can say, like, there are so many specific application of mass spectrometry. Okay, include drug testing and discovery, food contamination detection, okay, and pesticide residue analysis, and you can say carbon dating. I will also tell what is carbon dating, okay? But first we will take example like pesticide residue analysis, food contamination detection, drug testing and discovery, isotope ratio determination, protein identification, and last, simply carbon dating. Okay, and like guys, I want to tell one thing also to you. Like simply, you can say carbon dating is also refers to as radiocarbon dating. Okay, please guys, remember it. Carbon dating is also called as radiocarbon dating. Okay, and simply you can also call this as carbon 14 dating. Okay, and it's like nothing more. It's a method which is used to determine the age of any object which is containing organic material, okay, by the use of property of radiocarbon. Okay, radiocarbon means radioactive isotope of the carbon. Which isotope is the radioactive? Carbon 14. Got it, guys? So I think your doubt is clear. So Hrish, please go on.
Okay, thank you for Divyavan. Okay, a guide to interpreting mass spectra. Okay. Okay, mass spectrometer is an analytical technique that allows us to measure the masses of atoms and molecules. The most important peak in a mass spectrum is the molecular ion peak, which can be used to determine the mass of the molecule, but fragment ions can also provide information on chemical structure. Okay, now we are discussed about the steps of mass spectrometer. Okay, now how mass spectrometer works. Okay, now we are discussed. The first one, the sample is introduced to mass spectrometer. Only very small samples are required. A heater is often present to vaporize the sample. Okay. The second one, an electron gun ionizes molecules in the sample by knocking out electrons, producing positive ion. Some molecule break into smaller ion and fragment. Okay. The third one, the positive ion generated are passed through an electric field, which accelerates them into magnetic field generated by an electromagnetic. Okay. The fourth one, as the positive ion passes through the magnetic field, they are deflected. The lighter ions are deflected more than heavier ions, as are those with higher charges. Okay. The fifth one, the positive ions hit a charged plate and accepted electrons, creating a signal. The more ions that hit, the greater this signal. The output is a complex stick diagram. Okay. Now we see about step 15, 29, 30, 31, that like. Okay. Above are shown a selection of common fragment ions seen in a mass spectra along with their masses. Note that the structures shown are general representation, and it can also be possible for isomeric structure, those with the same constituent atoms but a different structure, to cause the peaks in spectra. There are also many more fragments possible than those shown, but knowledge of this should suffice to interpret spectra to most simple molecules. It is look like chemical bond structures also. So many chemical bonded is there. Okay.
So now guys, as you see, like Yashresh already mentioned, what is that electromagnet? Okay, guys. So simply, I am telling like in the first step, you can say like we will take a small sample. Okay, we are not going to take a large sample. The reason behind it is like, because if you take a large sample, then it's quite complicated to measure. Okay. Mass by charge ratio. Got it, guys? I think before some slide, you saw this thing, which I will tell. This slide, you saw this thing here. Okay. It's M by Z. Mass by charge ratio. Simple. It's simple. Not pretty complicated. It's so simple. Okay, guys. So simply you can say in second step, like there is a heater is present, that heater will like vaporize the that sample. After that, you can say this is the part from which you can convert that simple electrons into ions. Okay. If you will give positive charge, you will give negatively charged. Okay. And after that, like if they are passing through in the electromagnet means the simple magnet, when that magnet gets electricity, okay, then it converts into magnet. Okay. Like thing, this is a simple thing. Okay. Like maybe iron. Okay. If I provide electricity and that iron is converted into magnet, that is known as electromagnet. Okay. So simple. And like after that, you can say, it like we have electromagnet, that's why the deflection of the electron beam is also happens. Okay, guys. And in the fourth step, I already mentioned, in the fifth step, like you can say lighter ions are deflected more, okay, than heavier ion. Okay, got guys. So simple. It's the on this is the what you can say. What is this? Please tell me. What is the name of this? Detector. Okay. Detector. This is a part from which you can detect that, yeah, these are the ratio, like heavy are shown here, light are shown here, like that. Okay. So that is our topic and that is completed, guys. Okay. So thank you. And that presentation is done by Divya Bhansdang Rathod, Yashiresh Tippana Hegri, and Akhil Tirgar. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat, and Bharat Mata Ki Jai. Punar Darshanai.